So the death toll, as we have it confirmed as of yesterday, standing at 25, but the number of cases increasing by the minute, almost 3,800 cases.
Yes, Michelle, thank you. That's very true. The numbers continue to increase. As you mentioned, it's 25. By yesterday, it was 25 people who have died, and it's about 3,800 people infected. But what we understand, there is also the banning of churches this weekend, the banning of any gatherings by the police, because the government says they want to control the cholera scourge. What is happening now is international organizations like the health, the World Health Organizations and UNICEF are also helping, chipping in. And also the minister, as you mentioned, the Minister of Finance has opened an account for crowdfunding. But people are criticizing it, saying that the government is supposed to be the one which is releasing funds instead of asking people to donate into this account at a time when the economy is in its doldrums.
So, Pindai, the World Health Organization, saying that it is scaling up its response. We'll touch on the crowdfunding issue in just a moment. But what does that mean, scaling up the World Health Organization's response?
Yes, Michelle, because of the increase in number of people who are being infected, what we understand is that they will continue mobilizing resources like fresh water, medicine, to the people, to the areas which are most affected, that's Glenview and the Budiriro high density suburbs in southern Harare, in the southern part of Harare. So we understand that also police arresting vendors in the Glenview and Budiriro, you know, people who are selling in the streets of these two suburbs. And also they want to make sure that there is no more new cholera outbreaks, but it's still going on. And we understand also that they are mostly targeting those who are selling fresh meat and fish in the streets of these suburbs and also in Harare.
It's a massive outbreak, Pindai. 5 of the country's 10 provinces already affected. What we're hearing from the World Health Organization is that the first line antibiotics, the first course of treatment that would ordinarily be given to those infected with cholera, that isn't working. Do we know what the next step is then to try and curb more infections?
Yes, that's what we are hearing. But these affected other provinces, they are saying the people who spread the cholera in those provinces are from Harare. The Minister of Health pointed out that Harare remains the epicenter. Those provinces are affected by people who are traveling to this site, to those areas. And we understand that there were also issues of drug resistance, which we haven't proved yet. But when I spoke to some medical experts, they said they are doing all they can to make sure that the government is doing all it can to make sure that they control the spread of cholera, which is keeping on spreading.
All right. So a state of emergency declared in the city of Harare, that ordinarily would prompt the necessary funds to be released from government to try and help combat an outbreak of this sort. But now take us through this crowdfunding exercise. Surely the amounts of money that's needed here are massive. Who are the people or the organizations who are expected to contribute here?
Yes, Michelle, the Minister of Finance came up with this idea yesterday. He came on Twitter, especially on social media, saying that they are looking for funding. They are targeting corporates and other business people. But they are being criticized by Zimbabweans, that ordinary Zimbabweans, that this is happening at a time when they are expecting to get assistance from the government. You know, recently we had elections and there were MPs which were elected, and the people are saying that the government is splashing money on cars for the members of parliament and other government officials instead of diverting that money to deal with the cholera first, which has ravaged the Harare.
So do we know what that crowdfunding account is sitting at as yet, Pindai?
Not yet. We are waiting for the Minister of Finance, Mthuli Ncube, to tell us how much they have made so far. But some companies had already donated before the opening of this crowdfunding. We understand Econet, Wireless, and other companies had also donated.